The following tasks are required to integrate machine learning, ML, into planning. Importing and configuring a fully trained ML model into planning, which generates two Groovy rules. Associating one of the generated Groovy rules to a form or dashboard, or with the other Groovy rule, scheduling a job to generate large-scale predictions. The Configuring ML Model Import video tutorial covers importing and configuring the ML model. The Deploying an ML Model to Planning video tutorial covers attaching the rule to a form and scheduling a job to generate prediction results on a regular basis. Review the overview video for Bring Your Own ML, then review the video tutorial for Configuring ML Model Import before reviewing this video tutorial for Deploying an ML Model to Planning. You can deploy an imported ML model to make it available to planners on forms and dashboards. Planners can then use machine learning to generate a prediction. After importing a PMML file, which defines the ML model, EPM administrators integrate the PMML file into the planning application by associating the generated Groovy rule with planning forms. After configuring ML model import, two Groovy rules are generated. You use the form rule by associating it with a form or dashboard to allow users to make predictions on demand. You use the batch rule to generate large-scale predictions in a scheduled job for bulk processing. You can modify the rules to include any additional requirements. When the Groovy rule is finalized, you can associate it with relevant forms or dashboards. Let's deploy the ML model so that planners can use it. To deploy an ML model and integrate the PMML file into the planning application, planning administrators first create an action menu with the generated Groovy rule. Pick a form where the user would plan to run the prediction using the ML model. Ensure that this form has the necessary input and target variables that were mapped to the ML model. In this example, I'm editing product volume forecasting. The input variables, price, promotion, and industry volume, are in the bottom form, and the target variable or output is in the top form. Edit the bottom form. Select the Other Options tab. Select the action menu that includes the Groovy rule for the ML model and associate that action menu with the form. Now let's take a look at the end user's experience with the deployed ML model in the application. In volume forecasting, review the historical actual data in the top form. For driver data, there is average selling price, advertising and promotion, and industry volume. The driver data will be used to predict the product volume for future periods. I'll run the predictions by selecting it from the right-click menu. This triggers the prediction rule that in turn runs the rule using the ML model that was imported and deployed in the planning application. The rule picks the input drivers and gets the output, which is populated back into the planning form. The rule runs in the context of the form, predicting values only for cells on the form. Security is honored so that planners see predictions only for intersections to which they have access. Planners can run through various what-if scenarios to adjust their forecasts and plans or adjust the predicted values. Alternatively, administrators can schedule the batch rule to run on a regular basis. The batch rule runs for all cells for the full scope of the model, not just for cells on a particular form. As planners make predictions based on the ML model, administrators can measure the performance of the model and can work with data scientists to update or replace the ML model when needed. Then, administrators re-import and deploy the retrained ML model. When you re-import the retrained ML model, the Groovy rules are regenerated. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.